Hello everyone, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Ashim Datta and today we are going to discuss about brushless DC motor training system and its order code is 2223858.1. So in this video we are going to discuss about its components and its working. So this is the BLDC motor training system and this is the BLDC motor, and on the panel we are having, this is the main on off LED indicator, then this is the MCB on off switch, this is the auxiliary on off switch, this is the DC power supply section. Here we are having 48 volt DC output, 20 ampere, and this is the speed control section. Here we are having port for minimum and maximum speed control, then this is the brake switch for on and off, and this is the direction switch for forward and reverse direction. Then these are the voltmeter and ammeter. This is the digital voltmeter and this is the digital ammeter. Here we will read voltage and here we will read current. Then this is the BLDC motor input ports. Then this is the BLDC winding connection, R, Y and B. And this is the circuit explanation. And this is the Hall element sensor connector port. So from the motor, we are having this port, we will connect this wire here. Now we are going to perform an experiment on the kit. So the experiment we are going to perform is to study the running, reversing and braking of BLDC motor. So for that we have to do the connections first. So firstly we will connect the mains cord to the AC supply and then we will do the connections. So firstly we will connect this Hall element sensor at this port like this. So that is how the motor and the trainer is connected. Now we will do the connections on the panel. So firstly we will connect the negative to the negative of BLDC motor input section, then we will connect the positive of DC power supply to the V1 of voltmeter, then we will connect the negative of DC power supply to the V2 port of voltmeter like this. And now we will connect the positive of DC power supply to the ammeter A1 port like this. And now we will connect the positive of BLDC motor input to the A2 of ammeter like this. And now we will connect the R Y B of the motor to the BLDC winding connection like this. So that is how we will connect R, Y and B with the motor. So that is how the connection is done. Now we will switch on the MCB first and we have to keep the auxiliary switch at off position first, and we have to keep this direction switch at forward position first, and we have to keep this brake position at downward direction, and we have to keep the speed control of motor at off position like this. Now we will switch on the auxiliary switch so that our meters get on, and now we will slowly increase the speed control and we can see that our BLDC motor is running. So as you rotate this speed control port from minimum to maximum position, that is from in clockwise direction, so you will notice that the speed of the motor increases as you are rotating the speed control port from minimum to maximum position. So here you can see that the speed of motor increases and we are getting the reading for current and we are getting the reading of voltage also. So that is how you can take the readings of voltage and ammeter. Now here we have kept the direction switch at forward position, so the motor is rotating it in forward direction. When we will keep this brake switch at up position, currently it is at down position. So when we will keep this brake switch at up position, that is brake is applied, so we can see that the motor stops, and we have to again keep this brake switch at down position because we cannot apply brake for more than 2-3 seconds, it will damage the motor. So we have to keep the brake switch at down position. We can check this brake function just for 2-3 seconds, otherwise the motor will get damaged. So when you keep this brake switch at up position, you can see that the motor stops, and now again put this brake switch at down position for the safety of the motor. Now I will reduce the speed control to again minimum position, and now I will change the direction, that is in reverse direction. So by using this direction switch, we can change the reverse and forward of the motor rotation. Now I have kept this direction switch at reverse, so the motor will rotate in reverse direction. Now we will increase the speed control, and here we can notice that the motor rotating it in reverse direction. So as you increase the speed, that is you are rotating it in clockwise direction, that is the speed control is moving from minimum to maximum. So we can see that the speed of the motor increases in reverse direction, and you can take the current and voltage readings from ammeter and voltmeter, and you can form the table. You can also calculate the torque as mentioned in the experiment too, that is the study of speed control and load test of BLDC motor. So here you can calculate the torque. So you have to take the W1 and W2 readings from W1 and W2, that is the weight reading. So when you subtract W1 and W2, you will get the W value, and R is the radius of this. Radius of the pulley, so torque is equal to W into R into 9.8. So you will find the W value by subtracting W1 and W2. This is the W1 reading. Here on the scale you can take the W1 reading, and here on the scale you can get the W2 reading. So when you subtract W1 with W2, you will get the W value, that is the weight, and you can calculate or measure the radius of the pulley, that is the value of R, that is 55 mm, and when you multiply all of these with 9.8, you will get the torque. You can also see the formula in the manual. We have given the formula in the manual also. So that is how you can take the readings and do the calculations, and you can form the table here like this. So that is how you can form this table. Here you will enter different voltage values as you will increase the speed control port from minimum to maximum positions. You will get different values of voltage and current, and you can measure the different W1 and W2 reading, and that is how you can calculate torque and speed. Speed can be calculated by using the tachometer that is provided with this kit. So that is how you can perform both these experiments, experiment 1 and experiment 2. So that's all the demonstration from my side. If you have any query related to this kit, you can contact the Tesca Global website. You can find the link in the description. For more information, go through the manual. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe to our channel.